Balmoral in the Scottish countryside remains the epicentre of the nation's grief. For people in the small town, Her Majesty was a familiar face whom many knew personally. Tonight, tributes there are growing as preparations get underway to move the body of Queen Elizabeth II. Europe correspondent John Paul Gonzo is in Scotland and filed this report.
As rain continues to fall at Balmoral, so too do tears. The painful loss is felt personally in a place the Queen called home.
She just reminds me of, like, my gran. So, yeah, just like a grandmother figure, and, yeah, it's just a shame. She's always been here. I've always known to have a queen. It's just weird, it's strange.
Her Majesty spent summers here in the secluded Scottish countryside.
The Queen's corgis are Sugar and Susan.
She lived a relatively normal life, walking around the nearby village, going to church on Sundays and forging friendships with residents.
You know, we treat them as ordinary people up here, and they're just, you know, they're just part of the community, and we respect them for that.
And that community loved her back. The tributes left at the gates of Balmoral share the same message of just how much she will be missed.
She's got a remarkable memory, and she knows who so many people are. She's always got a nice story. She asks after family. She's such a lovely lady.
Balmoral held a very special place in the Queen's heart, and she was at peace here. Boris Johnson, who was one of the last people to meet with the 96-year-old, said she was as radiant as ever.
She just loved it here. She come here nearly every summer. The scenery, the peace and quiet. It was just at home as well.
A wave of grief is washing over Windsor too, where Her Majesty spent most of her time.
We had to come here today and just pay our respects because she's always been part of our lives, and we're very unlikely to ever have a queen in our lives again.
The castle is now without its queen. Mourners are still making sense of their grief and the renewal of the monarchy.
She's the only person I've known. She's been such an inspiration. I think such a woman to look up to. I'm never going to forget her, and I think that'll go for everybody in my generation.
After 70 years of unbroken service, her legacy will be eternal.
And John Paul Gonzo joins us now from Edinburgh, where the Queen's body will travel to first. JP, it's no secret many Scots do have mixed feelings towards the royals, but they do appear to have been put aside for now.
Lockie, Scotland has a difficult, at times fractured relationship with the monarchy. There's a push for independence here, but still we are witnessing an outpouring of grief at Holyrood House in Edinburgh, the royal family's official residence. Hundreds of bouquets, flowers, wreaths line the palace walls as people come down here to pay their respects. Even early this morning, we are expecting crowds to swell here in the coming hours and days. The city has been essentially shut down with barriers now in place and hundreds of extra police officers deployed to control crowds for when the Queen's coffin arrives. That is expected to be sometime tomorrow, but could change depending on developments today.
Okay, John Paul, live from Edinburgh. Thank you so much.